ప్రపన్న పాది జాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, వెల్త్, హెల్త్ అండ్ ఎథర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 11 ఆఫ్ 9th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ, అవజానంతి మాం మూఢాః, మానుషీం తనుమాశ్రితం పరం భావమజానంతః, మమ భూతమహేశ్వరం. మోఘాశా మోఘకర్మాణః, మోఘజ్ఞానా విచేతసః, రాక్షసీమాసురీం చైవ ప్రకృతిం మోహినీం శ్రితాః. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఫ్రమ్ వర్స్ నంబర్ 4 to 10, హీ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ ద నేచర్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ ఇన్ 6 ఫీచర్స్ ఆర్ ప్రిన్సిపల్స్. The first, he began with avyakta tattvam, God is formless, and sarvagata tattvam, God is everywhere, all pervasive, and adhisthanatvam, God is the sustainer, and asangatvam, God doesn't have attachment. Then he gave God is the karanam of srishti sthiti laya. Then finally, God is not containing karma phala. So these 6 kinds of features, principles, which is explained by God himself. And this has to be experienced as a devotee, as a person who has surrendered to him. This is not intellectual gymnastics. Studying about the God is nothing but exploring and experiencing the things. That's what we have seen. But there are human beings which is not able to explore our experience, because for them the God is only a kind of theory which exists in the Puranas and Vedas. God is a kind of support, so that is taken for the people who are confidentless. So for them, if a person who is confident enough, he need not to salute God, he need not to go to the temples, and he need not to even do any sadhana. So he should earn money, he should live a healthy life. This is what their idea is. That's known as healthy life. Healthy life means what? You live with your ideology, you live with your own effort. So that's what Paurusheyam means, Paurushatvam. They consider that is, you know, courageous thing. A courageous one should not even lean on or lean against God. He need not to take refuge. If he is able to live his own life without any bhakti, etc., etc., he is considered a man of the era. అంధేనైవ నీయమాన యథాంధాః, దట్ ఇస్ వన్ వర్డ్స్ ఇన్ ముండక ఉపనిషత్. ఇట్ టాక్స్ వెరీ నైస్లీ, ఇట్ డిస్క్రైబ్స్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్. సో దీస్ పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ లెడ్ బై ద బ్లైండ్, దే ఆల్సో కంటిన్యూ టు బీ యాజ్ బ్లైండ్ పీపుల్. ఇట్స్ అ వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్ వర్డ్స్. స్వయం ధీరా పండితం మన్యమానాః, జంఘన్యమానాః పరియంతి మూఢాః. సో దిస్ దోస్ పీపుల్ హూ థింక్ దెమ్సెల్ఫ్ దే నో ఎవ్రీథింగ్, దే సీ దే ఆర్ వివేకీస్, దే కన్సిడర్ దే ఆర్ వివేకీస్. సో దీస్ పీపుల్ సో హూ థింక్ దెమ్సెల్ఫ్ ఇంటెలిజెంట్, దే కెన్ నాట్ ఎంజాయ్ ద పాత్ ఆఫ్ వైదిక మార్గ. దేర్ఫోర్ ఇన్ ద 11th వర్డ్స్ సో భగవాన్ కృష్ణ సేస్, అవజానంతి మూఢాః, మాం అవజానంతి, దే డిస్రెస్పెక్ట్ మీ. ఫ్రమ్ వర్డ్స్ నెంబర్ 11 టు So verse number up to 15. So Bhagavan Krishna is giving many varieties of people. So in the level of ajnana, and there are people who is toddling and having dilemma with the bhakti and the life, having misunderstanding. So that those people are experienced here. Now let us understand why this happened. Okay, so that's what the human being, we have three level, means action requires three kind of requirement. We call it Ichha Shakti, then Jnana Shakti, then Kriya Shakti. But actually the sequence is Jnana Shakti is first. Jnana Shakti means what? So one should have the knowledge about something to desire. Otherwise he cannot have the desire on that particular subject. If you come to know there is a place called Paris, or there is a place called Switzerland, or there is a place called Simla, or there is a place, good place, let us say good place, Kedarnath, Badrinath, Kailash, and Vaikunth, Bhuloka Vaikunth, Tirumala, then you can desire, you can set the desires on that object or subjects. If you don't know, then you cannot have the desire on the subject. Now when the day begins, when you just begin your day with the newspaper, so what kind of desires will you set? So the desire, so which you are going to have, it's going to be up to the worldly desire. In avyavasayatmika buddhihi, you will set avyavasayatmika buddhihi, means you won't be clear enough with your destination. Not having proper knowledge about the destination, there itself the problem begins. Once you have the knowledge on something, you can have the desire. But the knowledge has to be 100%, and that knowledge has to be proper enough to make you reach the proper destination. So when a person is not depending on Vedas, what happens? Vedas, they know what we don't know, because we are dependent on our mind. Or okay, let us take intellectual people and intellect people who are dependent on their intellect. Okay, so intellectual aspects, but that buddhi is depending on the mind, because mind which gives the datas. So what is world? What is my family? What is the society? Therefore, what their ideas always belonging to the imperishable object. Not imperishable, perishable object. So only they want to achieve something which is perishable. Their goal, all of them, and they also think they are very intelligent. That is the goal. If anybody thinks goal, God as a goal, for him, they look like a mad. So he will criticize the person who fix God as the destination. That's what is happening now. But the devotee never worry about these people, because he knows. So moghasha, mogha karmanaha, mogha jnanaha. Now we are seeing the meaning of mogha jnanaha. So it's moham is different, mogham is different. Mogha jnanaha means alpajnaha, who don't have proper knowledge about anything. They don't have proper knowledge about their self. They don't have knowledge about the society. Society is not which is appearing as the society. So whatever is appearing, it's not the society. So those appearance, whatever you know, we call it we do have three kinds of memory, isn't it? So photographic memory and sound memory. And one more they say that, so except sound memory, we have got taste memory, and we have got a recollection, smriti memory. So understanding with the help of the appearance, it's known as photographic memory. And understanding with the help of sound, it's a sound memory. So understanding based on the movement, karma, and the other senses known as that karma memory. Karma means action memory. They know only the movement. So this, I think snake has got this kind of attitude. But photographic memory, what they see, they believe. The sound memory, what they listen, so only they think that's the world. But they don't know the connection between sound and seen. So seen means drishyam. What is seen, it can be different from what is heard. Our educational system now completely based on photographic memory. Therefore, in those days, there were not projectors, no computers, no laptops, no mobiles, everything photographic memory. In those days, education, I'm not talking about anything else than that. Means life can be depended on photographic memory or sound memory, doesn't matter. So when you live, so you can make use of this both memory and this karmic memory, means the action-oriented memory. I mean experience-oriented memory. So that three kinds of memory can be utilized when you live in a day-to-day life. But education must be based on hearing, means a sound memory. Therefore, we call Vedas as a Shruti, because through Shravanam alone, Shravana Dvarena Vidya. The education must be through Shravanam, because the sound memory, it lasts life, means it will exist a long time than other memories. This photographic memory has got less duration. Therefore, we have to depend on that. But people, what they see, they believe, not knowing the reality. Because our people nowadays, they do so many touch-up on outer appearance. Therefore, you cannot judge by that appearance who they are, how they are, what kind of nature they do have. In the same way, the nature has got its own phenomenon, its own capacity. That capacity is what? It's nothing but Prakriti, sir. You cannot judge what is going on in your body, mind and sense complex. All marriage, you know, the marriages is now not having any proper ideology. In those days, after marriage, they were clear what to be done. Now, only earning. Earning become the life. A human being should have only one job. The human being means they should know how to make money. And side by side, they should have, you know, some other knowledge, other talent like singing, dancing. Because dancing is very important. One should be part of parties. And this kind of small things. But main things, you should earn money. Which not at all our motto in our Sanatana Dharma. There was no money concept. So money has become main now. All other things have gone. Because of what? Because of photographic memory. Giving importance what is seen. Not giving importance what is the fact. So the appearance and fact, there is a huge distance. Maybe trillion, million miles, I tell you. Therefore, this mogahasha, mogajnanaha means, so the people who have wrong knowledge. The people who have wrong knowledge means what? The people who is not having proper knowledge, complete knowledge. They may have the knowledge, and they may pick something from the science, and they can say, they can talk, you know, there is no God. You see, you say there is Chandra Mandala, and in Chandra Mandala so many deities are there. 27 nakshatras are 27 devatas, and Rohini, who is married Chandra. Now you see, nobody is there in Chandra. So they can give this kind of you know, logical approachment to construct their false ideology. Because they only go with outside appearance. They don't know, they don't worry at all what is there inside. This incomplete knowledge is considered ignorance alone. That is ignorance. That person cannot fix a proper goal. That person cannot have proper life because that life becomes meaningless life. He cannot do anything meaningful because he believes this perishable world is shashvatam, nityam. Therefore what? So their desires, moghashaha, those desire based on only perishable things. Therefore those desire also not having consist ideology, consist progress, consist presentation, consist orientation. No, nothing. Because time to time, they have to keep updating. Therefore, only confusion. Now, simply when we can have the best example. Now, we have so many varieties of mobile which to buy. What mobile we should buy? And so many options. Swamiji, the world is full of options. So, in previous time also, there were options. No. Here, something is different. So, I think you know what I mean to say. Okay, let it be so many varieties of mobile. Why are you keep on updating? Because the science is developing. So, I have to keep myself with developing science. Okay, there's nothing wrong. But you should not consider the person who is not having knowledge about this mobile kind of this updation, you should not disrespect him. That's what is going on. That is wrong. So if a person is giving priority for the sharing love and sharing a proper knowledge, you should not disrespect, but which is going on now. There we commit mistake. When you are not having proper knowledge, you cannot set a proper desire. So when you are not able to sit proper desire, you cannot have proper action, my dear. Then these actions becomes vain. The actions which is not having proper legs, proper foundation, proper executing method. And these karmas will bring only papam. Because not knowing the nature of the karma, if you play with the karma, means connect with the karma with wrong, because wrong attitude is because of wrong understanding, you will find hell. The one example, you know, these atheist people, they used to marriage, means they used to arrange marriage in Rahu Kal and Yamakhand. I think you are aware about Rahu Kal and Yamakhand. So there is a, you know, reverse order. This Yamakanda is remembered as 6 to 7:30 on Thursday. Then Wednesday, you have to come reverse. So Wednesday it becomes 7:30 to 9, and Tuesday it becomes 9 to 10:30. So this is how we used to remember. And this Rahu Kal can be remembered with one sentence, which I learnt in the young age. After that, there are shlokas for that. Now we know what the shlokas to be. But in young age, so one person thought one line. Mother saw father wearing the turban suddenly. So mother for Monday, saw for Saturday, father for Friday. So like that, Rahu Kala, it begins from 7:30 to 9. So we have like that. This Rahu Kala, the time which is occupied by the Rahu, and Yamakanda, the time which is occupied by Yama, these times, so the auspicious things to be avoided. Okay, that's what the understanding. But purposely they got married, they arranged marriage, it was 25 years ago. After 7 or 8 years, you know, all the 7 marriages went vain. So all of them, they ended up with a tragedy. So these things, you know, we should not propaganda this, you know, we should not use this. So I felt very bad for those people who were victimized. Because, you know, people, you know, not having belief on God. If you don't have the belief on God, you cannot have belief on Panchanga. You need not to have the belief on the festivals. All the festivals are constructed in such a way that you can live with the concept of Ishwara. If you are not having main understanding, you cannot enjoy it. So this world, they have a live object, they have Ishwara in it. Even Prakriti herself, so every product contains Prakriti. The Prakriti Tattva which exists, you know, which contains programming for millenniums. Every object is pre-programmed. So now you should have the free will. Free will means you have the choice to select, you have the choice to reject, you have the choice to get different decision. That you need to have a proper training, you need to be informed how to utilize your free will, because all other materials are nothing but projection of your own karma phala. This is the proper understanding. If you consider rock is a mere rock, air is a mere air, water is a mere water, therefore we say this is H2O. It's not H2O, it is Ishwara. So chemically you name it and you know the chemical reactions, that's not enough. You should find Ishwara. You don't separate Prakriti, you don't separate the nature from Ishwara. When you separate, so is it possible to separate? No. But you separate, that's misunderstanding. When you misunderstand world is not Ishwara, then world will give what is dead material alone, limited things alone. Therefore, the moga jnanaha, moghashaha, moga karmanaha. This Lalita Sahasranama has one word, Ichha Shakti Jnana Shakti Kriya Shakti Namaha. This Ichha Shakti means you should have a proper desires. For that you should have the Jnana Shakti. That's considered as a Shakti. Shakti means what? Anugraha and power. A proper power which is blessings of Ishwara. It is nothing but blessings to have proper understanding, to have a proper desire. The desire which you have to construct a building, to construct a kind of institution, to establish an institution for the welfare of society. Okay, I don't say these people won't have good things for others. They also wish to do or perform good things for others, but it won't have long lasting aspects. That's what, you know, they cannot, because they are not aware of the Ishwaratvam. Jnana Shakti will help. So you have to have dependence, surrender on Ishwara, then Prakriti will flourish her blessings on you. Because Prakriti Tattva is completely depend on Ishwara Tattva. That's what we learnt. If you want to reject everything, then you cannot have a proper life. That's what the clarity. Avajananti means disrespect. Because of disrespecting, not giving value for this old concept, they cannot have meaningful knowledge, worthful knowledge. Then if they have meaningless, worthless knowledge, they will produce only meaningless, worthless actions. If they produce meaningless, worthless actions, then what? So they can have only meaningless desire, meaningless and worthless fruits. Then what will remain? We have the word for it. They will be confused. And those confused state is known as vikshepam. They remain in vikshepa. Vikshepa means what? Chaos. They are confused inside. They will create confusion. Therefore what? So they wish one confusion to another confusion. What I mean to say, they wish the object which will lead one confusion to another confusion. They will be keep on looking security, pleasure from this perishable object. They don't know beyond that. They don't talk about moksha. They don't talk about Ishvara. They don't understand Maya. They don't ask about the self realizations. These words are allergic to them. Therefore, they are known as Moodaha, completely deluded personality. So this completely deluded personality, but which thinks I am everything. That's what Rakshasim Asurim Prakritim Ashrita. They are deluded and occupied by two kinds of Prakriti nature, means aspects, Rajoguna and Tamoguna. Rajoguna brings Rakshasi attitude, means Rakshasi Bhava. They will act like Rakshasas. I think so many demons are introduced in our Purana. You imagine, so Krishna faced so many Asuras. And even Bhagavata, not only Bhagavata, Ramayana has got so many Asuras. All the demons are occupied by Rajoguna. All the demons. So there are two categories, Rakshasas, Asuras. Asuras means they are also demon, but they are occupied by Tamogunas. So these Rakshasas who are dominated by their ego, but these Asuras who are dominated by inferiority complex. Rakshasas have superiority complex. Asuras who are dominated by inferiority complex. Therefore, what? Both will always want to rule the nation, rule the world. Therefore, all chaos. This Moghasha means, Moghajnanaha means having wrong understanding, lack of jnana shakti. Moghasha means lack of Ichha Shakti. Mogha Karmanaha means completely lack of Kriya Shakti. Okay, you need to have these three kind of power when you want to lead your life in proper way. For that, you need to have the blessings of Mahamaya. Mahamaya means what? Para and Para Prakriti. Together is known as Mahamaya. We'll continue to next verse. Mahatmanastumam partha devim prakritim ashritah bhajantyananyamanasaha nyatva bhutadim avyayam. Now Bhagavan is explaining the people who are endowed with Ishvara Jnanam and who fix Ishvara as their desire or destination and who perform action as a sadhana, so completely, so altogether called a devotee, bhaktas. Okay, so that we will see from next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.